Welcome back. I did finish uploading and charging my camcorder. Let's read about atomic layer deposition. I don't know what it is, but this is why I like to read it. It's 2 p.m. I've been tired and sleepy my whole day because I only sleep 2 a.m. in the night. And the temperature is getting up and up and up. Now it's soon 30. So it's 30 degrees in the daytime and 25 in the nighttime. 24, 25. And that's going on forever, every day, months and months and months and months. But not in the winter, November, December, around January, I need to put the heating on. But this heat going on forever in my apartment, like 9 months. Every day, 8-9 months. From early spring to late autumn. Make a new plastic bank. Put water because I only have 2 bottles. I will cook this sausages later. I got this potato today, super super cheap. Only $1.50, 2 bags. $1.50 each. Cheap carrots. Got some cheap red grapes. So let's read. Now it's 2 p.m. So the temperature will get up like the next 2 hours to like 30. Then it will drop slowly again to 25 or 24 the whole night. That's going on forever. It never stops. Yes, it will stop in the winter. Of course, in the Scandinavian winter, the sun is not shining so many hours. So every day the sun is shining few more minutes every day. So we have to wait. I had to wait many weeks. The sun is shining like 5 hours less every day. No, then the sun get up like 9 a.m. and go down 4 p.m. Then it's not possible to get so to 30 degrees.
Atomic layer deposition. Atomic layer deposition, ALD, is a thin film deposition technique based on the sequential use of a gas phase chemical process. It is a subclass of chemical vapor deposition. The majority of ALD reactions use two chemicals called precursors, also called reactants. These precursors react with the surface of a material one at a time in a sequential, self-limiting manner. A thin film is slowly deposited through repeated exposure to separate precursors. ALD is a key process in fabricating semiconductor devices, and part of the set of tools for synthesizing nanomaterials. Introduction, edit. During atomic layer deposition, a film is grown on a substrate by exposing its surface to alternate gaseous species, typically referred to as precursors or reactants. In contrast to chemical vapor deposition, the precursors are never present simultaneously in the reactor, but they are inserted as a series of sequential, non-overlapping pulses. In each of these pulses, the precursor molecules react with the surface in a self-limiting way, so that the reaction terminates once all the available sites on the surface are consumed. Consequently, the maximum amount of material deposited on the surface after a single exposure to all of the precursors, a so-called ALD cycle, is determined by the nature of the precursor-surface interaction. By varying the number of cycles, it is possible to grow materials uniformly and with high precision on arbitrarily complex and large substrates. ALD is a deposition method with great potential for producing very thin, conformal films with control of the thickness and composition of the films possible at the atomic level. A major driving force for the recent interest is the prospective seen for ALD in scaling down microelectronic devices according to Moore's law. ALD is an active field of research, with hundreds of different processes published in the scientific literature, though some of them exhibit behaviors that depart from that of an ideal ALD process. Currently, there are several comprehensive review papers that give a summary of the published ALD processes, including the work of Puurunen, Mikulainen et al., Noops et al., and Makas and Schneider et al. An interactive, community-driven database of ALD processes is also available online, which generates an up-to-date overview in the form of an annotated periodic table. The sister technique of atomic layer deposition, molecular layer deposition, MLD, uses organic precursors to deposit polymers. By combining the ALD/MLD techniques, it is possible to make highly conformal and pure hybrid films for many applications. Another technology related to ALD is sequential infiltration synthesis, SIS, which uses alternating precursor vapor exposures to infiltrate and modify polymers. SIS is also referred to as vapor phase infiltration, VPI, and sequential vapor infiltration, SVI. History, edit. 1960s, edit. In the 1960s, Stanislav Koltsov, together with Valentin Ailskovsky and colleagues, experimentally developed the principles of ALD at Leningrad Technological Institute, LTI, in the Soviet Union. The purpose was to experimentally build upon the theoretical considerations of the framework hypothesis coined by Ailskovsky in his 1952 habilitation thesis. The experiments started with metal chloride reactions and water with porous silica, soon extending to other substrate materials and planar thin films. Ailskovsky and Koltsov together proposed the name molecular layering for the new technique in 1965. The principles of molecular layering were summarized in the doctoral thesis, Professor's Thesis, of Koltsov in 1971. Research activities of molecular layering covered a broad scope, from fundamental chemistry research to applied research with porous catalysts, sorbents and fillers to microelectronics and beyond. In 1974, when starting the development of thin-film electroluminescent displays, for, at Instrumentarium OY in Finland, Tuomo Suntila devised ALD as an advanced thin-film technology. Suntila named it atomic layer epitaxy, AL, based on the meaning of epitaxy in Greek language, arrangement upon. The first experiments were made with elemental Zn and S to grow ZnSAL as a means for growth of thin films was internationally patented in more than 20 countries. A breakthrough occurred when Suntila and co-workers switched from high vacuum reactors to inert gas reactors, which enabled the use of compound reactants like metal chlorides, hydrogen sulfide and water vapor for performing the AL process. The technology was first disclosed in 1980 CID conference. The full display prototype presented consisted of a ZnS layer between two aluminum oxide dielectric layers, all made in an AL process using ZnCl2 plus H2S and AlCl3 plus H2O as the reactants. The first large-scale proof-of-concept of AL displays were the flight information boards installed in the Helsinki Vantaa Airport in 1983. Full flat panel display production started in the mid-1980s by Lodger Oy in the Ola in Luoma factory. Academic research on AL started in Tampere University of Technology, where Suntila gave lectures on electron physics, in 1970s. And in 1980s at Helsinki University of Technology. Full display manufacturing remained until the 1990s the only industrial application of AL. In 1987, Suntila started the development of the AL technology for new applications like photovoltaic devices and heterogeneous catalysts in Microchemistry Limited, established for that purpose by the Finnish national oil company Neste. In the 1990s, AL development in microchemistry was directed to semiconductor applications and AL reactors suitable for silicon wafer processing. In 1999, Microchemistry Limited and the ALD technology were sold to the Dutch ASM International, a major supplier of semiconductor manufacturing equipment, and Microchemistry Limited became ASM Microchemistry Oy as ASM's Finnish daughter company. Microchemistry Limited /ASM Microchemistry Limited was the only manufacturer of commercial ALD reactors in the 1990s. In the early 2000s, the expertise on ALD reactors in Finland triggered two new manufacturers, Benic Oy and Pekka Sunoy, the latter started by Sven Lindfors, Suntila's close co-worker since 1975. The number of reactor manufacturers increased rapidly and semiconductor applications became the industrial breakthrough of the ALD technology, as ALD became an enabling technology for the continuation of Moore's Law. In 2004, Tuomo Suntila received the European Semi Award for the development of the ALD technology for semiconductor applications, and in 2018 the Millennium Technology Prize. The developers of ML and AL met at the first International Conference on Atomic Layer Epitaxy, AL1 in Espoo, Finland, 1990. An attempt to expose the extent of molecular layering works was made in a scientific ALD review article in 2005 and later in the VPHA-related publications. The name atomic layer deposition was apparently proposed for the first time in writing as an alternative to AL in analogy with CVD by Mark Kuleskela, professor at the University of Helsinki, at the AL1 conference, Espoo, Finland. It took about a decade before the name gained general acceptance with the onset of the International Conference Series on ALD by American Vacuum Society. 2000s, edit. In 2000, Gatij Singh Sundu and Trung T. Doan of Micron Technology initiated the development of atomic layer deposition high films for drum memory devices. This helped drive cost-effective implementation of semiconductor memory, starting with 90 nm node DRAM. Intel Corporation has reported using ALD to deposit high-gate dielectric for its 45nm CMOS technology. ALD has been developed in two independent discoveries under names Atomic Layer Epitaxy, AL, Finland, and Molecular Layering, ML, Soviet Union. To clarify the early history, the virtual project on the history of ALD, VPHA, has been set up in summer 2013. It resulted in several publications reviewing the historical development of ALD under the names AL and ML. 2010s, edit. In 2010, sequential infiltration synthesis, SIS, first reported by researchers at Argonne National Laboratory, was added to the family of ALD-derived techniques. Surface reaction mechanisms, edit. In a prototypical ALD process, a substrate is exposed to two reactants A and B in a sequential, non-overlapping way. In contrast to other techniques such as chemical vapor deposition, CVD, where thin film growth proceeds on a steady-state fashion, in ALD each reactant reacts with the surface in a self-limited way. The reactant molecules can react only with a finite number of reactive sites on the surface. Once all those sites have been consumed in the reactor, the growth stops. The remaining reactant molecules are flushed away and only then reactant B is inserted into the reactor. By alternating exposures of A and B, a thin film is deposited. This process is shown in the side figure. Consequently, when describing an ALD process, one refers to both dose times, the time a surface is being exposed to a precursor, and purge times, the time left in between doses for the precursor to evacuate the chamber, for each precursor. The dose-purge-dose-purge sequence of a binary ALD process constitutes an ALD cycle. Also, rather than using the concept of growth rate, ALD processes are described in terms of their growth per cycle. In ALD, enough time must be allowed in each reaction step so that a full adsorption density can be achieved. When this happens, the process has reached saturation. This time will depend on two key factors, the precursor pressure and the sticking probability. Therefore, the rate of adsorption per unit of surface area can be expressed as R sub ABS equals S asterisk F. Where R is the rate of adsorption, S is the sticking probability, and F is the incident molar flux. However, a key characteristic of ALD is the S will change with time. As more molecules have reacted with the surface, this sticking probability will become smaller until reaching a value of zero once saturation is reached. The specific details on the reaction mechanisms are strongly dependent on the particular ALD process. With hundreds of processes available to deposit oxide, metals, nitrides, sulfides, chalcogenides, and fluoride materials, the unraveling of the mechanistic aspects of ALD processes is an active field of research. Some representative examples are shown below. Thermal ALD, edit. Thermal ALD requires temperatures ranging from room temperature, tilde 20 degrees C, to 350 degrees Celsius for ligand exchange or combustion type surface reactions. It occurs through surface reactions, which enables accurate thickness control no matter the substrate geometry, subject to aspect ratio, and reactor design. The synthesis of Al2O3 from trimethyl aluminum, TMA, and water is one of the best known thermal ALD examples. During the TMA exposure, TMA dissociatively chemisorbs on the substrate surface and any remaining TMA is pumped out of the chamber. The dissociative chemisorption of TMA leaves a surface covered with AlCH3. The surface is then exposed to H2O vapor, which reacts with the surface CH3 forming CH4 as a reaction byproduct and resulting in a hydroxylated Al2O3 surface. Plasma ALD, edit. In plasma-assisted ALD, PA-ALD, the high reactivity of the plasma species allows to reduce the deposition temperature without compromising the film quality. Also, a wider range of precursors can be used and thus a wider range of materials can be deposited as compared to thermal ALD. Spatial ALD, edit. In temporal ALD, the separate precursor and co-reactant doses are separated from each other in time by a purge step. In contrast, in spatial ALD, SALD, these gases are delivered at different locations, so they are separated in space. In atmospheric pressure SALD, the precursor and co-reactant are delivered continuously and they are separated from each other by a gas curtain to prevent gas phase reactions. Such gas curtain typically consists of nitrogen injection and exhaust positions, see figure 1. As a substrate moves through the different gas zones, self-limiting reactions take place at the substrate surface and the ALD process takes place. As this process can easily be accelerated, the deposition rate for spatial ALD can be much higher than for conventional ALD. For example, for ALD of L2O3, the deposition rate increases from 100 to 300 nm per hour to 60 nm per minute. The inline nature of spatial ALD makes it suitable for high-volume production lines and roll-to-roll production. In general, SALD has been employed to apply moisture permeation barriers, passivation layers in silicon solar cells and functional layers in batteries. The chemistry for spatial ALD processes is comparable with typical temporal ALD processes, and materials that have been explored include inorganic metal oxides such as L2O3, algodoped, ZNO, CiO2, N2O3, INSNO, LiPol, ZN, OS, SNOX, and TOX, but also PMG metals, PT, IR, RU, can be deposited. Additionally, organic molecules can be grown in combination with inorganic atoms to enable molecular layer deposition, MLD. Plasma or ozone-enhanced spatial ALD has been demonstrated, which generally lowers the deposition temperatures required. Photo-assisted ALD, edit. In this ALD variety, UV light is used to accelerate surface reactions on the substrate. Hence reaction temperature can be reduced, as in plasma-assisted ALD. As compared to plasma-assisted ALD, the activation is weaker, but is often easier to control by adjusting the wavelength, intensity and timing of illumination. Metal ALD, edit. Copper metal ALD has attracted much attention due to the demand for copper as an interconnect material and the relative ease by which copper can be deposited thermally. Copper has a positive standard electrochemical potential and is the most easily reduced metal of the first row transition metals. Thus, numerous ALD processes have been developed, including several using hydrogen gas as the core reactant. Ideally, copper metal ALD should be performed at less than or equal to 100 degrees C to achieve continuous films with low surface roughness, since higher temperatures can result in agglomeration of deposited copper. Some metals can be grown by ALD via fluorosilane elimination reactions using a metal halide and a silicon precursor, for example CiH4, Si2H6, as the reactants. These reactions are very exothermic due to the formation of stable Si-F bonds. Metals deposited by fluorosilane elimination include tungsten and molybdenum. As an example, the surface reactions for tungsten metal ALD using WF6 and Si2H6 as the reactants can be expressed as ZF2H** and WF6WWF5** and Si F3H. WF5** and Si2H6 ZF2H** and Si F3H plus 2H2. The overall ALD reaction is WF6 plus Si2H6 W plus Si F3H plus 2H2, H equals 1H1. The growth rate can vary from 4 to 7 a/cycle depending on the deposition temperature, 177 to 325 degrees Celsius, and Cl2H6 reactant exposure, tilde 10 to 10 L. Factors that may influence Cl2H6 insertion into CH bonds and result in a silicon CVD contribution to the tungsten ALD growth. The thermal ALD of many other metals is challenging, or presently impossible, due to their very negative electrochemical potentials. Recently, the application of novel strong reducing agents has led to the first reports of low-temperature thermal ALD processes for several electropositive metals. Chromium metal was deposited using a chromium alkoxide precursor and BH3, NHme2. Titanium and tin metals were grown from their respective metal chlorides, MCl4, M equals T, SN, and Abyss, trimethylsilyl, 6-membered ring compound. Aluminum metal was deposited using an aluminum dihydride precursor and AlCl3. Catalytic CO2-ALD, edit. The use of catalysts is of paramount importance in delivering reliable methods of CO2-ALD. Without catalysts, surface reactions leading to the formation of CO2 are generally very slow and only occur at exceptionally high temperatures. Typical catalysts for CO2-ALD include Lewis bases such as NH3 or pyridine, and CO2-ALD can also be initiated when these Lewis bases are coupled with other silicon precursors such as tetrahydroxysilane, TIOs. Hydrogen bonding is believed to occur between the Lewis base and the CO(H**) surface species, or between the H2O-based reactant and the Lewis base. Oxygen becomes a stronger nucleophile when the Lewis base hydrogen bonds with the CO(H**) surface species because the CH bond is effectively weakened. As such, the electropositive Cl atom in the CiCl4 reactant is more susceptible to nucleophilic attack. Similarly, hydrogen bonding between a Lewis base and an H2O reactant make the electronegative O in H2O a strong nucleophile that is able to attack the Cl in an existing CiCl** surface species. The use of a Lewis base catalyst is more or less a requirement for CO2-ALD, as without a Lewis base catalyst, reaction temperatures must exceed 325 degrees Celsius and pressures must exceed 10 TOR. Generally, the most favorable temperature to perform CO2-ALD is at 32 degrees Celsius, and a common deposition rate is 1.35 angstroms per binary reaction sequence. Two surface reactions for CO2-ALD, an overall reaction, and a schematic illustrating Lewis base catalysis in CO2-ALD are provided below. Primary reactions at surface. CO(H**) and CiCl4 show Cl3**, plus HCl. CiCl**, and H2O CO(H**), plus HCl. Overall ALD reaction. CiCl4 plus 2H2O CO2 plus 4HCl. ALD reaction mechanisms. Type of ALD, temperature range, viable substrates, reactants, applications. Catalytic ALD, 32 degrees C with Lewis base catalyst metal oxides, i.e. TO2, ZrO2, SnO2, metal, Cl4, H2O high K dielectric layers, protective layers, anti-reflective layers, etc. Al2O3 ALD 3300 degrees Cl2O3, metal oxides, metal, Cl4, H2O, T, OPR, 4, metal, IT, 2 dielectric layers, insulating layers, etc. Solar cell surface passivations. Metal ALD using thermal chemistry 175-400 degrees C, metal fluorides, organometallics, catalytic metals M, C5H5, 2, CH3, C5H4, M, CH3, 3Cu, THD, 2, PD, FuC, 2, Ni, Ac, H2 conductive pathways, catalytic surfaces, MOS devices. ALD on polymers 25-100 degrees C common polymers, polyethylene, PMMA, PP, PS, PVC, PVA, etc. Al, CH3, 3.